Hey, it's Keely. In this lesson, we're going to learn how to factor more complex expressions. This will help us on our journey to solve tricky equations and plot some crazy graphs. Make sure you've completed the intro to factoring lesson before starting this video. Ready? Let's go! We already know how to factor an expression like 2v plus 4. We find the greatest common factor between the terms, which in this expression would be 2, and we factor it out, giving us 2 all times v plus 2. But what do we do if we have a complex expression like 2x minus 6y plus 4z, or 5xy minus 10y, or 3k squared minus 6k? Well, let's find out. Let's start with this expression, 2x minus 6y plus 4z. Right off the bat, what do you notice? I see three terms and no like terms. They all have different variables, right? Do you think there are any common factors we could factor out? Well, let's see by breaking up our three terms into its factors. Our first one will give us 2 times x, that would be 2 and x. And our next term, that would give us 6 and y. And our third term, that would give us 4 and z. Do you see any matching ones? Not yet, but I'm pretty sure this 6 we can break down, right? We could get 1 and 6 or 2 and 3. And now I have a matching factor here with this 2. Now, what about my third term, my 4z? Can I break this 4 down? Yeah, it could be 1 and 4 or it could be 2 and 2. And what do we notice? Oh yeah, we have some matching terms, all of these twos here. So let's rewrite our expression here using the factors. So our first term, that would give us 2 times x minus our second term, which would be 2 times 3 times y, plus our third term, which is going to give us 2 times 2 times z. Now, I want to take a look at these matching factors here in each term. And we have these matching factors. So what do we do with our matching factors? We can take them out, right? So that means we factor them out, we put our parentheses, and we're going to put the rest of our factors for each term inside the parentheses. So for our first one, if we had 2 times x and we took a 2 out, we're going to be left with an x minus our second term. We also took a 2 out, so we're left with 3y plus our third term. We did the same thing. We took a 2 out, so we're left with 2 times z. So you did it. You factored a three-term expression. Nice job. Okay, so now we have another tricky expression. What do you notice? Yeah, two terms and any like terms? Well, not exactly, but both terms do share one of the same variables, y. But our first term has two variables, and that's a little crazy. So let's see if we have any common factors. Do you notice any right away? Yeah, this variable y is actually a common factor. So right from the start, we can factor this y out. So if we pulled that y out, what would we be left with? 5x from our first term minus 10 from our second term. Do you see how that works? Since we could write both of these terms as having a factor of y, we can just pull it out right away. And now we can just focus on factoring the expression inside our parentheses. So let's start with 5x now as our first term. How can we factor 5x? 5 times x, yeah. And what about our second term? How can we factor 10? 1 times 10 or 2 times 5? Now, again, do we see any common factors here? Yeah, both of these terms have a factor of 5. So 5 and 5 are our common factors. And let's just focus on inside this parenthesis right now. If we wanted to factor out these 5s, what would we be left with? So I'm pulling my 5 out from my first term. What will I have? Yeah, just my x minus, what will I have left in my second term? Just my 2 here. So 5x minus 10 breaks into 5 all times x minus 2. But remember, I have this y already out here. So what do I do with this y now that I've factored inside my parentheses? So this is really looking like y times 5 times x minus 2. But I can just multiply this 5 and the y together, and I will get 5y times x minus 2. Whoa, pretty fancy, right? Now, let's double check using the distributive property to make sure that this right here is our correct factored form. So I'm going to multiply 5y times x, and that will give me 5yx minus 5y times 2 would give me 10y. Now, does this expression match this expression? Yeah, the only difference is here we have x times y, and here we have y times x, but we know that that means the same thing, so it checks out. Nice work! Okay, final example. We have 3k squared minus 6k. This one looks pretty tricky, especially with that exponent. But let's take a deep breath and do what we know. We can look at each term one at a time and break them down into their factors. So for the first term, what this is really saying is 3 times k squared, and k squared is really k times k. So term number one looks like 3 times k times k. Now our second term, 6k, breaks up into 6 and k. And can we break this 6 up at all? Yeah, we can get a 3 and a 2. So my second term looks like 3 times 2 times k. So this is my expression, all factored out. Now, do we see any common factors here? Yeah, I see a 3 in blue and a 3 in purple. And I have a k in blue and a k in purple. So does this mean I have 2 matching factors? It does. And that means I can pull both of the factors out. So 2 matching factors in both of my terms mean I can pull out 3k, and I will have my parentheses for what's left in each term. What do I have left in my first term if I pulled out the 3 and the k? Just a k. And then in my second term, what do I have left if I've pulled out the 3 and the k? Just a 2. So my factored form would be 3k times k minus 2. And just to be sure, we can double check using the distributive property. 3k times k will give me 3k squared minus 3k times 2 would give me 6k. Checks out. It does. So that's our real factored form. Wowza, you are learning a ton of pre-algebra. Now you can practice factoring complex expressions on your own. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.